Well, I guess I better begin on my project. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take these light fixtures down. Just remember, if you remove light fixtures, make sure you've got the switch turned off and everything's set to go. Now, the best thing to do before you think you're just going to disconnect it up high and take it down, you want to take these globes off. The shade here, you got to be real careful with that, and you don't want to get that broken because these are hard to replace. You ever had to replace one of these shades before? You'll know what I'm talking about. So I'm going to be real careful with it. I'm going to unscrew these little tabs here, take that out, put those away safe before I start working on the rest of the light fixture. Be careful with those. Usually you have to undo all these screws here, but check this out. I just loosened this one up and this thing came down. The reason why is because they didn't do these evenly all the way around. Here's a tip for you. When you get ready to put these back up, what you want is you want all of these screwed out the same way, the same length. You can kind of feel that. Then you can hold that up there, two screws, two screws, two spins, and then another one, 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 something like that. So that you get it on this little throat the proper way, because they didn't have it on here properly. They held it up, whoever did it, they didn't know what they were doing. They screwed these two over here tight, really far, and then this one here, they hardly had to do anything at all. And once I did that, undid that, this thing came down. So just be careful as you're pulling those down, because sometimes you undo one, if you let go of it, all of a sudden it might come crashing down. So I don't make any assumptions. I always be careful when I take these out. That's another reason why you want to pull this globe down first. Had I tried to start unscrewing things like that and thought, oh, I'll be careful, I'll just pull that down and I'm moving it around, all of a sudden the shade could have came down because it was only held with one little screw. I'm looking at this one here, and look at this. This whole vertical rod is out at the top. I may never have known that had I just thought I was just going to paint everything in place. Now I can go ahead and fix that too after I get ready to put it back up. I mean, these it's supposed to be sturdy, but this one's out. And if I look up there and tilt it, I can even see the wire sticking up there. So I guess I'm going to have to be careful with that when I put it back together. Don't worry, I'm not going to show you how to remove all these light fixtures. I think you can figure that out on your own. But if you've got questions, every light fixture goes together a different way. So you just have to kind of look around. On this particular one, there's screws up in here. There's three screws around here. So I'm going to have to undo that. And then this whole thing is going to pop down that way. Then I can get to the wire nuts and all that. Okay? But just take your time. It's really pretty easy for something like this to do yourself. Take that out, pull the wires down, undo the wires, and remember how it goes back together. Usually it's white to white, black to black, and ground to ground. That's on most standard fixtures. When I pull this out, I'll show you. Now see, I just undid the three screws here, around here. This drops down, and it's just being held by the weight of the wire nuts. And see, there's three wire nuts here. I just want to briefly look at that and see which is which. No, ground to ground is the bare copper to the bare copper. I find something interesting here. This particular wire over here, it's a white wire coming down, And it's a black wire coming up out of the light fixture, a black wire coming out of the light fixture here. So I might want to mark these in case it makes a difference which one to hook up later from which to which. You don't necessarily want to swap those around depending how the light fixture was wired up inside or anything. So I'm going to be careful with that. This has some white sheathing on it, on this cord coming up. And on the black, the one going up to the black, I'm going to put a black felt tip pin mark on that one, I think. That way I'll know that that one gets hooked up to the black, and this other white sheathed one gets hooked up to the white up there. That's all I'm going to do. I think you can take it from there. Just undo those wire nuts, hang on to this so it doesn't fall down. If you have a helper, that's good too. Just kind of showing you how I do things by myself. Sometimes it's easier to have two people doing a project, but here I'm just by myself, so it'll work. I'll get her done. Just wanted to quickly show this. Here's my wires that I took off. Interestingly enough, there's a ground screw right there that's in this mounted box. Now they could have taken the ground wire coming out and connected it to the ground screw there, and then the ground wire coming from the light fixture, they could have attached there too. Now, for some reason they decided not to do that, and it was probably okay. You're supposed to have everything grounded, but you know, once they had that screwed in there and the metal cover gets screwed onto here, you're basically grounding everything. So I think they would have been fine with that. If you ever have a question, if you ever happen to see a ground screw in your light fixture outlet box or something, it's a good idea to get it connected. Okay, so now this box here, wow, it's even loose. This box here, I'm gonna just undo these two screws. I'm gonna pull this down. Okay, that way when I patch and you get ready to paint, I'll have this out of my way too. You know what I mean? Be much easier if I just get that out. Just two screws are holding it, and I'll be done. At this point, I'm just going to make sure that the mounting screws are tight in there, and they seem to be. Now, that one's loose. There. Wow. Okay. I'll just keep the box up there tight. If that was on a ceiling fan or a heavy light fixture, chandelier light fixture, I would have been glad that I just tested that out. Okay. And another thing you'll notice, see the black ridge around here? Well, that was caused by this rubbing up there and where the trim of the light fixture went around there. Once I patch and get this all painted, chances are this is going to go away, but I want to make sure that doesn't bleed through my paint. So I might want to put a little bit of primer over there, because if I don't, if that bleeds through, at least I'll have to make sure, at least when I put this back up there, if I happen to see a little ridge there, I can adjust this slightly over or whatever to make sure I'm going right around there. So when I put the trim back up, you know, the whole light fixture, that the trim is going to cover that. Last thing I want is for the trim to stop short of this line and be pushed over that way too far or something, and then have that line show. So just a few things to think about, you know, as you go along, and I'll remember those things. Now these wires are dead, but I'm just going to, because I have the light switch off, but I'm going to just go ahead and put the wire nuts back on here. You know, sometimes they happen to fall off. If they do, you could put some tape on there, put a smaller wire nut on there. I don't really need one on the ground, but the ground wire, but I'm going to put one up there anyways. I want to kind of push this back up here and kind of have it
up in the box so that when I run my paint roller across here, when I'm getting ready to paint, these wires are out of my way. And for sanding and the wall, taping and skimming the wall and all that, okay? You just kind of twist your wires back up in there. Kind of put them behind those ears of the light fixture box. Now when I paint, it'll go right across there. I won't have to worry about that. Sometimes the light fixture outlet box is deeper than that. This is called a pancake box. It's only a half inch deep. And that's all you really needed here. But lots of times, lots of light fixture boxes are maybe an inch and a half deep plastic box that goes up into the ceiling. Well, just happened to be the location where this one was. Maybe there was a ceiling joist there, exactly where they wanted the light fixture or something, then they used a pancake box. There's all kinds of different ways to install light fixture rough outlet boxes, and this is just one of them. Now that you did such a nice job helping me with that first one, I'm gonna let you do that second one all by yourself.